When you're ready to respond to a conversation, you'll type your response into the composer here. When the composer is set to reply and the background is white, you know you're writing a response to a customer. Smart replies, like this, are suggested in the background of the composer when you first reply to a conversation. These are greetings that you most commonly use. Hit the Tab key to add it to your reply, or if you don't find it useful, just type as normal. In your reply, you can use macros. These add message copy and can trigger workflows. Click the macros icon in the composer, or type hashtag, choose from this list, or start typing the name of the macro. Macros are great for speeding up workflows and using consistent responses in conversations across all teams. If there are any conflicting actions like assignments to different teams, the most recently added action won't occur. To manually choose an action, just remove any conflicts. The content of your message can be edited using our AI capabilities. Either open the Actions menu by hitting Command and K and searching for AI, or highlight a word, phrase, or sentence to see the formatting menu. You can use Expand to take a prompt and automatically make it into a sentence or paragraph. This works best with a description. If you'd like to rephrase any of the response, you can choose this option. You can make the reply more friendly or more formal, depending on your company's tone. And finally, there's a custom prompt which gives you direct access to the bot. You can ask general knowledge questions, reformat, or translate your message. This option should be used with caution, and always make sure to review and edit your message before sending. You can add lots of content to your reply too. Either show shortcuts by clicking here, typing Command and K, or by clicking the three dots in your composer here. If you use any of these content types a lot, you can pin them to your composer by clicking the pin icon next to it here. They'll be here for you to access with just one click next time. You can also quickly add emojis to your reply by typing colon and the name of the emoji, like this. To format your reply, highlight it to choose from this menu. You can bold, italicize, add inline code, and hyperlink your text. You can add headings and code blocks too. When your text is highlighted, you can also use keyboard shortcuts. Hit Command and B to bold text, and Command and I to italicize. As always, Command and Z will undo any formatting you add. If you want to add another customer to your conversation, you can loop them in by email. Click on the name of the customer in the composer to add more email addresses. You can also hit Command and K and type Manage Participants to add an additional email. If you'd like to remove someone, you can click their name or just use a backspace to delete them. When you're ready to send a reply, click the Send icon beside your response. You can also hit Command and Enter. Beside this icon, you have options to send and close and send and snooze your conversation. Snoozing a conversation will temporarily remove it from your open conversations list for a set period of time. Then, when the snooze period ends, or if someone replies, it'll reopen, reminding you to follow up. To snooze a conversation, you can also click the moon icon in the top toolbar and choose how long you want to snooze the conversation for. You can also quickly snooze a conversation until tomorrow by hitting Z. Let's just hit send or Command and Enter to reply to the customer, and we're all done.